I nearly forgot to turn the alarm off, but I turned the alarm off, and I heard that, and I thought, well, it's still going.
I'm just trying to get a mic working that they can hear.
Thank you.
Testing one.
Oh, good. It's working. Okay. Okay, so I'm going to have you clip this on. I cannot hear you.
Okay.
That has a clip.
Can you hear me now?
I can go check.
Go check if you can hear me now. Okay. So we're alternating. One, two. This next one is going to go in the back with the mouth facing back. Okay. Going to face front, back up. The next thing is our wind chest. In my instruction manual, I say, so there, it looks like an organ. So what are we missing? The wind. It's not going to play anything until we get the wind on there. In the back of this, fine with the back. It's a hole underneath. So this pipe is going to go through here. It's gotten squeezed. Yes. Okay. Okay. Mm-hmm. So far, good, huh?
I think.
I know.
See if I slipped up on one of these back ones. I don't think so.
Looking good.
Things are like,
oh, I know it. Yes, 10, 20 feet tall. Yes,
you know.
Exactly. Okay. Then this is going to go. This is called the wind trunk. The wind trunk. I tell it looks like an elephant trunk. Okay. So it's going to have to do this right. The hose is going to come through here. So that has to come down here. Okay. I don't know. Are we viewing this, Mark?
Yep.
Are we? So, where's the camera? Okay. So here's the organ. It's connected to the, what we got, sound? What are we missing? Pull the stop, duh. Thank you. Okay, so that's a... Ta-da! Front 4 foot is good. 2 foot. Ta-da! Okay. It's an organ.
There it
is. Miriam, are you going to play something?
Later.
Okay, so. That's, you know how to play. That's the way family knows that is the thing. Okay. So you notice that there's C sharp down at the bottom. And the only explanation that have in is wasn't room in the frame for it. Well, then, duh. So I don't know the explanation, but so it looks a little strange. But you have to. This is a C here. Okay.
To avoid certain keys on
the yeah, that's right. No C sharp available to you. So.
So we did not fly in a famous organist to do a recital.
She flew. She drove in.
On this.
She's going to play this. With the pipe organ.
No, by itself.
Okay. By itself. All right. So, and let's put together instructions. This all comes with the organ. So, step 1A, frame assembly. Okay. Step 1B, keyboard assembly. Show the keys all mixed up here. And he's out of order. 1C is a tracker action assembly. Step 1E is the wind. And then they even have instructions on how to pack the crate, which is pretty impressive because it needs to be just perfect. Then here's an organ assembly overview. So if you have 30 kids, can you imagine? A frame team assembles the frame. Keyboard team arranges the keys in order. Tracker action team attaches the trackers to the pull-down pins. Investigate the mechanism, explore the function of the sliders. Pipe team sort the pipes into two groups, open, closed, arrange pipes. Order and install them on the tow board, and then the wind team. And so then they tell you, you know, which of these is gonna come first, and then now for some music. So we've not done this with multiple kids. I have no idea what kind of chaos that would be. I think you'd need a lot of adults to one with each team to work with it. So that's down the line. So, but some of these instructions we thought were a little confusing. So I've kind of edited some of these. Rich has edited some, is putting his in, what do you call it?
We'll print them and get them laminated.
Laminated, yes. They can go in a book too. So, and I've got a way to do this out on a table. So we're learning as we go. But that's the animal. So, okay. Any questions? Oh, thank you. All right. What's next, Miriam? You're here. What's next?
We're checking with Mark.
Checking with Mark. Okay. You can see how the bells. Miriam, I'm going to check to see how the tuning jives with the Orgel Kids and the pipe organ. So. Yes. Mm-hmm. Pipes are in good order. Oh yeah. Aren't you glad we don't have a mutation stop in there trying to figure out? And you can see there's enough space in the back that you can hear the tone come out of the...
Oh, yeah.
He's the on.
Beautiful, doesn't it?
Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
It's a nice tone. Yeah, that's not, impossible.
Not really. Sends out a little.
Yeah, uh-huh. A little echo in here. You can feel it takes more wind. I like it. Good for you.
He's getting tired of it. In the bell over there. It's like the old pump organ. I mean, you never did bottom out. You learned how to. How to
that's right. Uh huh. Yep. It's all a learned skill, isn't it? Yeah. Did you ever have to do that?
No, just.
You sound like you know what you're. Like, well, you know, talking about.
Sometimes you would visit a family that.
Okay.
Had
okay.
One. You're good.
Thank you. CIAGO projects include welcoming all the kids who are safe to CIAGO, which we supported with Deanna. This is the result of a visionary design in the Netherlands in 2009 to empower people to build a portable working library. In the past 2 years, the work by CIAGO executive members, especially from the On September 21st, 2020, for outreach efforts throughout Iowa, and for the great generosity of our current sub-dean, Dr. Stevenson, regularly offers financial incentives to reply directly to his people designates. We are partnering with organizations and centers in central Iowa. In our new reality, we are researching, deciphering artifacts of thought, composing
Lord, we thank you indeed that they reflect your image, this beauty that they create for us. Thank you for dedication, discipline, as they practice. Lord, we thank you also for those who built this building originally and since have invested in it, and for the gift of the instrument. Lord, we ask that you would bless the hearing, and you would bless the that indeed people would experience your love and power. Even now during this service, that we would sense your presence. Thank you, Jesus.
And before we have the blessing and dedication, I just want to say a couple things. When we talk about dedicating or blessing an object within a worship service, if you go back to the Old Testament, that literally means to set something aside for God's purposes. In other words, this has been dedicated to a certain use. It's not just for any old thing, and it has a focus. And so as we ask God's blessing on this instrument and its use, we also then give it to God and say we set this aside for purposes of helping people understand better what it means to have worship leaders through such a marvelous instrument as an organ. So let's pray together. Lord, I give you thanks for the craft that's been put in this instrument, for the mind who thought it up in the first place, for the people who had the vision to bring it Central Iowa, and for the people who invest funds in making that possible. Lord, we would ask that you would bless the results of all the effort of these people, that you would be with us as we use this to your glory, as we introduce people young and old to how the pipe organ is designed and made, and through that, perhaps, Lord, you would ignite passion in people, that they would indeed hear your call become leaders of worship in your houses of worship. We pray boldly for this in your name.
One of the things that I have observed new on the block is the passion that many of you share for the organ, its music, its leadership and worship. And I think just in my brief interaction we set up service, I was so impressed with your commitment as well. And so I want to give gratitude and thanks to former Central Iowa agency officers and the executive committee members. And that would be Deanna Snyder as dean, David Bloomer as dean, secretary, and then executive committee members Beb Duffy, Christopher Ellerston, Dr. Michael Ellerston, and Zach Hastings. And again, thank you so much for all that you have done to contribute to this chapter and also in ministry. And we now continue the litany. And please stand if you're able, whether you're online or in person. And if you have a bulletin, we'll print, ask you to read. And I will also read aloud for those of you who are online as well. So let's begin. The mission of the American Guild of Organists is to enrich lives of organ and organ music. To achieve this, we encourage excellence in the performance of organ and music, inspire, educate, and offer certification for organists and choral conductors, provide networking, fellowship, and mutual support, nurture future generations of organists, promote the organ and its historical evolving roles, and engage wider audiences with organ and choral music. Do you, members of this guild, commit yourselves to these principles? If you answer, we do. For the greater glory of God and for the cause of fine music in this land, we declare our belief that the office of worship is a sacred oblation and that they who are organists and choir directors in the house themselves be people of devout conduct and excellent purpose. Brothers and sisters of this guild, do you affirm this covenant? We give ourselves reverence and humility to these endeavors and offer our talents, our skills, our work, and in the name of God, with whom nothing is wrong, nothing is holy. Let us pray. God of majesty, be present with your servants who seek through your gift of music to perfect our praises and to proclaim your word with power. Through this ministry, grant new awareness of your beauty and grace, and make us all worthy at length to join the praise of the hosts of heaven through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We will, please be seated. We will continue with a musical meditation, Veni Sancto Spiritus, and the verses are sung by Dylan Brown, cantor at St. John's Episcopal Church in Ames, and they will be in Latin, English, French, German, Spanish, and Italian.
Seven.
At this point, we have the installation of chapter officers, and that all of you who are officers here, Miriam Back, Stephen Smith, Silla Franken, Mark Koskamp, Mark Schultz, Paul Hertz, and Mark Singer Harries, if you are in the room, you will please rise. So we have all together said our litany of commitment. And I would ask, do you desire to support the ministry and purposes of the Central Iowa American Organist today? So please say, we do. So I declare you now to be hereby installed for a wonderful, amazing, and adventuresome year of creativity and opportunity. Please be seated. We continue with our closing music, Earth and All Stars.
As you all know, we cannot sing today. However, we wanted people to be able to participate. So as you came in, you should have been given a bell. Normally, we probably wouldn't attempt this without practice with normal people, but we're organists, right? So, Pastor, if you could forward one screen, please. Okay, so on the screen, the melody that the organ will be playing is on the top line, and there are notes for the bells on the bottom line. If you look at the end of your bell, you'll see which one you have. You'll be playing along with the organ every other verse. When there's ties, go ahead and just keep ringing. When they're not ties, just sing at the measure. I will warn you that it gets more complicated as we go along. So we're starting off pretty easy here. So if you would rise and join us with your bells in lieu of your voices in Earth and All Stars.
going, and you're getting up, you're rising down. May the Lord be with you in your work and in your play, alone and when you are in community. And may the Lord give you a profound sense of his presence throughout this year, in spite of every challenge, that they may become avenues for creativity. May the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We continue now with a postlude. Please be seated.
Thank you.
Yep, I'm just ending the stream.